In this video, we are building 7 cursed nether portals inside Minecraft. Each of these portals gives us a unique effect when we go through and enter the nether. Now, the first portal we're crafting, guys, is going to be building a nether portal, but instead of using obsidian, we are going to be using these ores around the area. Now, gather the ores however you like. In this case, I've got ourselves a pickaxe with silk touch on it, so we can just go up and gather enough ores to build ourselves a portal. You, my friend, are going to stay right there and not bother me. Quickly grab as much ore as we need in order to get our portal built out. It could be any ore that we want. In this case, we got a whole awful lot of coal here, so let's just gather all that. And once we have all of the ore that we could possibly need, we're going to go and build this portal. Each of these, well, I should hold myself right there. Not all of these are built the same way. The ore portal, however, is going to be built exactly like a regular nether portal. Get ourselves all of our ore blocks laid out. It could be any ore that we want. This case, we've got ourselves our coal ore. Then we got to grab ourselves our flint and steel. We're going to sneak up right next to our portal and light her up. You can see we got ourselves a nether portal, a extremely cursed nether portal. Jump through and see what effect we get on the other side. Something tasty. What do we have here? And going through the ore nether portal gave us an aurified effect. Whenever we're in the nether now, if we've entered through an ore portal, we're going to have this aurified effect. And this is a perfect spot because now all of the netherrack in the area is going to drop an ore drop. Coal, very funny that you're playing me because we went through a coal portal, but it can be any possible ore drop that we could ever want. Gather it up, gather it up, gather it up, gather it up. There we got some diamonds to show up finally. More diamonds. Get ourselves a straight tunnel here, just gathering up all of these ores. Anytime, anywhere we go, doesn't matter how far away from the portal that we are. While we're in the nether here, check it out. We always have this aurified effect. It is not going, oh, okay.
I just lost myself a diamond. That lava got in my way.
That's okay. Any other netherrack, we just go this direction and farm it down. I want to get enough diamonds so that we can get full set of tools, full set of armor, and then we head back for some more. Our total take in the nether, all of this lapis, redstone, we've got 25 diamonds, 34 raw gold, almost a stack and a half of raw copper, and 24 emeralds on top of 24 raw iron and 27 coal. Not bad for quickly building ourselves an ore portal. Head right back through and let's get beefed up just a tad. Boom and boom and boom. We've got a full set of diamond armor. Our pickaxe broke before we could do more than that, but this will be good for our nether adventures. For our next cursed nether portal, we need to gather up a bunch of wood because we're going to be crafting an entire nether portal out of chests. Turn all this into our planks and start crafting up all the chests that we're going to need here. Give me more wood. Okay, toss all this in here. Gather all that up. Just a couple more chests. Boom, boom. Too many chests. That's okay. Nothing wrong with way too many. All we have to do first is place one obsidian block and then grab all the chests that we have and place them all around. Once we have them all placed around in some funky looking fashion, we light it up and we've got ourselves, honestly, the weirdest looking nether portal I have ever seen. This thing looks absolutely bizarre. And here goes the moment of truth. We're gonna jump in. Let's find out. Oh, it's working. It's working. And what effect do we get from this? We have a nether chest effect. What in the world is a nether chest effect gonna do? And all we have to do with this nether chest effect is, well, start fighting as much as we can. Just start fighting and get ready to run. Okay, so as you can see, we made ourselves a very, very, very large pickle here, and we are in a bit of danger. That's okay. We'll make some progress here. This is going to take me just a minute to clear up, my golly. Come on, give me all you got. Give me all you've got. Almost got you all. And finally, yes. As you can see, all of those those guys just dropped us an individual chest each that we can now go and pick up. Get myself to safety. Now check this out. And we can take these chests that we just picked up, open them up, and they are going to be filled with loot. All of them filled with different loot drops or trades that we could get from piglins. 3 ender pearls in this one chest. Oh my gosh. And I didn't even see this. 4 blaze rods? You've got to be kidding me. Potion of fire resistance? Woo! That's just one chest right there. We didn't even go into this chest back here. More ender pearls. More blaze rods. More gold ingots. All of them are completely full. Blaze rods, ender pearls, gold ingots, blaze powder. What else can you need? I mean, seriously, we've got 27 of these chests still on hand, and we just got 15 ender pearls and 20 blaze rods and 15 blaze powder. And a slightly better option might be finding somebody that's a little bit more isolated and taking just one out at a time, because even just one of these chests is going to be more than enough than what you could ever need. Oh my word. The next cursed nether portal build that we're checking out, I like to call the inside out or inverted portal. We're basically taking what's on the outside and shoving it to the inside so that the portal is stuck on the outside. All we've got to do is build a portal basically so that the obsidian is inside rather than out. You'll see what I'm talking about. Once we've got our obsidian block set up, all we do is light one side of the portal. Look at that thing. How cursed is this? What is holding this portal in place? It's literally just floating outside the obsidian. Like the obsidian is just sucking it in and holding it to it. But despite that, we can still go through this inside out portal, and I have absolutely no idea what to expect on the other side. Oh my gosh. Oh my word. What in the nuts is this? What are we picking up here? Is this netherrack? It is. This is netherrack. This is the most bugged version of the nether ever. This looks like it should be x-ray vision. We got blue fire over there, like a ghost netherrack. Oh, and this, is this gold? No, that's the nether quartz ore. That makes sense. That makes sense. That makes sense. How would you be able to get around in the nether when your entire game is looking like this? I mean, you can still definitely spot the mobs there. The water looks like some sort of fungus. I just said water because it's blue. I didn't even realize. That is not possible. That is definitely lava. That up there, I have no idea what that would be. Let's get over there and test it out. Clear, 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 clear the netherrack. Oh no, that's lava. That's lava that just came down on me. Oh my word. Hold on a second, folks. Jeez Louise, don't die. Please don't die. We're burning up in blue fire right now. We are burning up in blue fire. We've got some safely right here we can test instead. Bust you down. Let me see. It's glow dust. That's what it is. No wonder it looks so different than the nether quartz. Ooh, wait. I think this might be the gold. Yes. Look at that. Look at these gold nuggets. These gold nuggets. 5 gold nuggets. You're telling me that's gold? That is not gold. That's like a lapis. Like a lapis nugget. Oh, we're back to the quartz now. They're so hard for me to tell apart. No. Oh, it's the blue. That's why the lava looks blue. That yellow and orange and red is now all like some sort of inside out inverted blue. And the gold then also looks somewhat blue. This is bizarre. I gotta get out of here. This is just funky. A white portal around and a gold yellow portal color on the inside. Get me out. This effect is way too crazy for me. I'm done with the inverted nether. I prefer the color of the overworld. You, my friend, are busted. Completely busted. Forget that cursed inverted portal. Let's move straight on to the next one, which is going to be a nether portal built completely out of glass. All the way up on all sides. Doot, doot, doot. There we go. Let's go in with the flint and steel. Light this bad boy up. We can definitely tell that for certain is a nether portal. Ooh, the world looks normal. We've got this effect called glass. Is this something with the glass? If we break the glass inside, oh, everything breaks so fast. When we've gone through the glass portal, all the blocks just bust instantly. Okay, we need to be very careful not to send ourselves falling to our death. That would be highly unfortunate. Make our way over, and let's find out, are these mobs also fragile? How's it going, buddy? I don't think they even realized how fast I took him out. I was like an assassin. They just stayed right where they are. Let me help you out. Bye. Now I feel completely fearless running around in the nether. This in combination with our nether chest effect would be insane because all those mobs we had to hide from, we'd just be able to instantly knock all of them out. Bye. Bye, bye. Definitely useful to have this effect if we were gonna go farm some blazes, but let's get back because we got more portals to check out. We are going to build a nether portal completely out of beds. Open this up. Let's go. One bed here, another bed there, and a bed there. All we've got to do is grab our flint and steel and we're instantly teleported. I think we actually got some of our beds back. I sure hope you're gonna take me back to the surface when I need to get back, buddy. Don't just leave me here in the nether. But there's one way we can confirm if the bed portal worked correctly. Let's go into a crafting table and craft ourselves using gold and oak planks. Oh my word. Look at this thing right here. We got ourselves a piglin bed. Pull that down. Ooh, it looks so cute with the pig head on it. Let's go out this direction to find ourselves some piglins. And yes, here we go. Okay, perfect. Make our way down to the piglin and we've got to get this bed right near that piglin. Don't worry, we're gonna be okay because we have this super beds effect, which is going to allow us to safely put down this bed right there, and instantly he goes right to sleep and starts having the best dream of his entire life. He is spitting out all of the loot that he has on hand. We can literally stand next to this one guy for forever. He will not wake up from this deep slumber. Oh my gosh, he's having such a great dream right now. Look at that. You and your buddies, everybody stand around and grab this loot. And once you're finished with the piglin, one more bed we gotta craft. This one can be a bit dangerous, but get yourself the planks and some lava all the way around. Get yourself a blaze bed. Now, once you have the blaze bed, go find the nearest blaze you can find. Toss down the blaze bed and our blaze is gonna go right to bed, just like the piglin, and he's gonna start dropping all of his blaze rods on the ground there. Then we can just quickly gather up all of them. Excuse me. It's just me and Blaze tonight, folks. We're hanging out. I'm gathering blaze rods. He's not going anywhere. He's gonna stay in that blaze bed for eternity and be spitting out in this Minecraft world blaze rods for forever. All right, buddy. Thank you very much. I hope you have a wonderful night's rest. I've got to get back to the overworld. We're gonna use some of those supplies that we got from those sleeping piglins, craft ourselves a bunch of blocks of gold. Then using these blocks of gold right here, we're going to upgrade them into a new block. Just like that, we get ourselves a gold blaze block. All we've got to do with the gold blaze blocks is set them up just like a normal portal would be. And now, oh, look how cool that looks. Go up to the portal. 3, 2, 1, light. A golden nether portal. But we're not going to be running through it. Instead of entering the golden nether portal, what we're going to do is take any item that we want and toss it right into the portal. Watch this, right through, and it instantly changes. And if we don't like any of these items that we get in return, guess what? Just grab them and toss them back in to the portal, and we can get whatever we want in exchange. Those end pearls, that's what we want. But we've got one final portal to beat all portals. We are going to need, though, end portal frames in order to do it. Place one block of obsidian down, and then build this thing out. Oh my gosh, light up. And we get ourselves our end portal frame nether portal. Ooh. Hi, guys. Hi. Yep. How you doing? See ya. As you can see at the top of the screen, we have our Ender Dragon health bar there. But we don't have to fight a dragon. Any mob that we fight in the nether, and we have the End Nether effect, we are automatically going to deal damage directly to Mrs. Dragon herself. Let's get to this. Oh, geez. Buddy, back off. Why did you have to come right this second? My goodness. Come on, Junior. Let me beat you down. I dare you. I dare you. Oh my gosh. Look at that. We get ourselves, bang, instant game finisher.